all set up. Now let's go cook some soup.
Okay, get out the Coleman stove. Tyler, you did remember the Coleman stove. Tyler! That's the only thing you had to remember!
I thought you were getting it! I asked you to do one thing!
No, I set up this whole thing! I told you to bring the Coleman
stove.
You
set up this whole thing, or I set up this whole thing?
Didn't.
You were laying back!
Oh, good one.
Yeah. You never do anything!
You know what? There's plenty of ways we can cook some food.
Why don't we just throw a pot on a fire?
Lose a hand, that's a good one. You never put a pot directly on an open fire because the surface is uneven and removing the pot can be dangerous if the flames get too high. Come on, I've got plenty of ways to suspend pots over open fires. Wait, did you grab the rope?
Yep, got it.
So how about those different methods you were talking about?
Well, there's two methods I'd like to use. The first one is the tripod rig, and the second is the log pivot rig, which I will demonstrate in class.
Okay, so what do those look like?
Well, the tripod rig, it looks like what it sounds like. It's basically a tripod. You take three sticks and you tie them together, and you have another stick going across the tripod, and that's what you'll hang your pot from.
Okay.
And the log pivot rig is a little bit different. There's two sticks, and they have it kind of looks like a fork because you need that so one of the sticks can lay across the stick that's in the ground, and then you can hang your pot from the second stick. And if you want to make it more stable, you can put a stone under one of the fork sticks so it doesn't fall.
Okay, that sounds good. That might make a little bit more sense to you guys if we demonstrate.
Yeah, because it's kind of complicated, but I'll show you, don't worry.
Alright. Okay, so what do we need first?
First you need a pile of sticks and something to cut them with.
Okay, so what do we need to do with these?
Well, you're going to need one long one to lay across your tripod, and then three of roughly the same length to make your tripod. And then you're going to need a small and slightly wider one to put into the ground at the end.
Alright, let's do it.
Alright. I got a pocket full of sunshine. I got a love and I know that it's all mine. Oh, whoa. Do what you want, but you're never gonna break me. Stick some stones, are never gonna shake me. Oh. Sticks we will be using to make our tripod rig. The long one at the end will be placed across the top of the three sticks in the middle, which will be used to make a tripod, and the last one will be used as a stake. So now what I'm going to get you to do, Tyler, is sharpen this stick so we can put it in the ground at the end.
Okay, which end do I have to sharpen?
Well, you would sharpen from this end because that's the way the fork is going, and when you put it in the ground like this, the string would go up here and it wouldn't be able to fall out.
Okay, perfect. I'll do that.
A go that nobody knows where the rivers flow, and I call it home, and there's no more lies in the darkness is light, and nobody cries, there's only butterflies.
And now you have your sharpened stick to put into the ground.
So Morgan, how are we going to secure these logs together?
Well, the first thing you have to do is learn how to make a clove hitch, which is a very simple knot, which I'll demonstrate for you right now.
Okay, so you're passing it over, looping it around, bringing that one around. Okay, makes sense. Thank you. Okay.
Last thing you do is just pull it tight. Like that. And that's a clove hitch.
That's it?
That's it.
What a simple knot.
So what do we do now?
All right, well, the next step is what I like to call the over and under. And the official term is lashing. But basically what you do is you move the rope over and under the logs a numerous amount of times until your rope is secure. So just keep going back and forth through the logs with just one of the ropes. One of the ropes stay down here.
But the first time they both go over, right?
Yeah.
So how many times should I do this?
You should have, at the end of it, 3 at the bottom. But it's basically until the ropes are secure. So it can be up to you. That should be good there, though.
So what do we do now?
Well, the next step is called frapping. And it's to secure your stick so that you can form the tripod. So you're gonna take the rope and pass it over the other ropes and through the logs.
Just once?
No, you're gonna do it twice.
Okay.
Between each, so you're gonna do it twice here and then twice on this one.
So that's good now?
Yep, and then you're gonna take the rope and pass it through here, through these two logs.
So right here?
On this side.
All right, is that it for that step?
Yep, that's how you do the technique called frapping.
Okay.
Okay, so now I'm gonna get you to do a technique called half hitching the rope.
All right.
So you're gonna bring this rope around the last log.
Okay.
And then you're gonna pass the end of the rope through this loop right here.
All right.
And you're gonna repeat this one more time.
The same way?
So, yep, do it the exact same way.
Okay.
And then you're just gonna pull it tight. Perfect.
This is taking so long. When's this gonna be done?
Tyler, quit complaining. Stand the logs up and see what happens.
Oh my god. We made a tripod!
Good job!
Thank you! You're a good teacher.
So if you're noticing that you didn't tie your rope quite tight enough, you can loop the extra rope around a couple times. Take me away! A secret place! A secret place! Sweet
escape! Take me away! There. Alright, let's go finish and cook some soup. So we're good now? We can cook some soup?
Well, if you want to burn your tripod down, but for us, I'd suggest using the 2 sticks from before.
Okay. So now you're just tying a clove hitch, right?
Yep.
Okay, and then we're going to tie it to the other stick and then pound that into the ground?
Yep.
All right, sounds good. Take me away, take me away, take me away. To cook now?
Yep, let's go get the pot.
Alright. Oh boy, I can't wait to get some soup. This is looking good.
Yeah, I mean, it was a lot of work, but it was worth it.
Good job, Morgan.
You too, Tyler. I'm proud of you. Take me away. Take me away. Take me away.
Which end do I sharpen?
I would say this end, because it's smaller. And that's the way the fork goes, so it only makes sense that you would... I didn't know you.
Alright. Where are we going?
Yay!
You're almost hitting my finger.
Jesus.
Okay, that was good one. You never set a pot on a...
We first... Proud of you too.
I can't do six.
You weren't even looking at me when so we started.
I don't know what you're doing.
You ruined the video!